Excellencies and dignitaries on stage, dignitaries in the audience, dear friends, it's always very difficult to speak last because whatever I wanted to say has already been said. As they say, friend, tout sauf son déjà dit. But nevertheless, I will have a say. Dear friends, the year 2017 is a very important year for ASEAN and for the India-ASEAN relations, as already mentioned by many other speakers. This is the 50th anniversary of ASEAN, the year India and ASEAN are observing 24 years of dialogue partnership, 15 years of summit-level cooperation, and 5 years of strategic partnership. Hence, this year is marked by a wide range of activities both in India and all of ASEAN countries. India and the countries of ASEAN have enjoyed historical and cultural links over thousands of years. In modern times, these links translated into excellent bilateral relationships with each of the ASEAN countries and a strong partnership with ASEAN as a whole. ASEAN is India's fourth largest trading partner, the bilateral trade of around 70 million annually. Investment flows are also substantial both ways, with ASEAN accounting for approximately 12.5% of investment flows into India since 2000. Foreign direct investment inflows into India from ASEAN from 2000 to 2016, about 16 years, was about $50 billion. And FDI outflows from India to ASEAN from 7 to 15 was about $39 billion. The ASEAN-India free trade area is now complete with coming into force of the ASEAN-India agreement on trade in services and investments from the 1st of July 2015. The ASEAN-India Business Council was set up in 2003 in Kuala Lumpur and Dato Ramesh Ji told us as a forum to bring key private sector players from India and ASEAN countries onto a single platform for business networking and sharing of ideas. And it's certainly a very happy event that now we have a chapter of that in Lagos, the Lagos chapter headed by a friend, Habib Chowdhury, who is largely responsible for today's event. And with, of course, the LSE supporting him to the best of his ability. ASEAN-India connectivity is a matter of strategic priority, as my friend Ambassador Supra mentioned. Connectivity is the core issue between ASEAN and India. And that's where Northeast India comes in. It's a matter of strategic priority for India, as it is for the ASEAN countries. India has made considerable progress in implementing the India-Myanmar-Thailand trilateral highway and the multimodal project. Issues related to increasing the maritime and air connectivity between ASEAN and India and transforming the corridors of connectivity into economic corridors are under discussion. A possible extension of India-Myanmar-Thailand trilateral highway to Cambodia and Laos. Our beloved Indian Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji announced a line of credit of $1 billion to promote projects that support physical and digital connectivity, and we are working very actively with the Lao government to see how we can actualize this offer. And I'm sure the other ASEAN countries are doing the same. There are several other India-ASEAN projects in the pipeline in various areas, agriculture, science and technology, space, environment, and so on, including in our media. We are working on that. Now, coming to our specific case from India, the states of Arunachal and Manipur, I'm supposed to be giving a word of thanks. My heartfelt thanks, sir, both the states for having come here with delegations because. Look east, act east, but we can only act east when actually we act east. And you have brought the delegation and you have showed our commitment with a great symbolic value to the principle of act east. You are actually physically here and we are now exploring possibilities for cooperation. And I think that is what we need. Now what we need to do. My apologies, I always have a problem with mics. I'm too short to... Can everybody hear me? What I was trying to say, sir, is that now that we have acted east, what we need to do is actually devise, sit down, delegations from both sides, sit down and talk about specific projects between specific states and specific countries in Asia. I'm the ambassador to Laos, so I'll stick to Laos. Between Laos and Arunachal Pradesh, Laos and Manipur. What can we do in the field of culture? What can we do in the field of commerce? What can we do in the field of tourism? And also draw on the commonalities. As some of the speakers mentioned, there are ethnic similarities, there are linguistic similarities, there are religious similarities, there are cultural similarities, and we should leverage all this in order to develop our cooperation. And Ambassador Sultan, you should definitely visit, go beyond Guwahati and see other parts of Northeast. And once we create some kind of a working group which can come up with specific projects, I think that's when the cooperation actually starts. This is my humble submission to the gathering here. With these few words, thank you very much. And of course, without all of you being here, we cannot make anything happen. So thank you very much for coming here, spending your valuable time. And let's hope that this is the beginning of a great and new era for cooperation between Laos and Northeast India. Thank you very much.